we just pray, we just kept praying and praying, like, God, just, Lord, you could do it so easily. Like, your storehouses, like, your provision is never short. So God, would you just please bring a miracle and renovate these spaces? We are just really humbled at the provision of God. And I don't know why we keep on, why do we keep doubting? You know, why do we get overwhelmed? Because there's still days. I think it was just like last week. We're like, man, there's so much to do. There's so much stuff that we need to do and so much that we need God to figure out that we don't know how to do. And like, look at this, it's happening. It happened across 3 different buildings. Come in. Welcome to the Sacramento home. We have 2 bathrooms over here. They busted both of them open. And now you have a giant ADA compliant bathroom that wheelchairs can come in.
Really exciting being here in this house, seeing everything that's changed over just a couple of weeks here in this house, and then the one next door and the one down the road. So we opened the Booth home with 6 beds just a month and a half ago, and that even was just super exciting because up until that time there were only 8 beds available really in the Houston area and really in all of Southeast Texas for adult victims of sex trafficking. There are so few beds devoted to that just in the United States in general, less than 700, and 2/3 of those are devoted to minors. So adult women really don't get the attention they need in victim services. So expanding from the 6 beds to these multiple homes that we have is so key to providing additional services, especially this home with the ADA compliant, you know, bathrooms and wheelchair accessibility and stuff like that. We've received, just in the short time we've been accepting referrals, 3 to 4 women who could use ADA services, one in a wheelchair, several with walkers, that are victims of trafficking, that their vulnerabilities have been exploited through their disability, and it's difficult to find them placement because they don't have the accessibility that's needed in most of the facilities that are available now. So besides the expansion of beds that we're going to be able to provide, the services that we'll be able to provide through the different homes, through having multiple homes with up to, you know, 15 to 20 beds, we'll be able to provide a place that women with disabilities will be able to come and receive services, which is going to be unique to Elijah Rising and to the Restoration Campus here.
You know, over the past 3 years, all of this, this house, all the other houses, all of this property, 84 acres, has been worked on by so many of you. So we just want to say thank you to all of the donors and the volunteers who have gotten us to this point, who have made this possible. We're so thankful for 8 Days of Hope because of what they're doing, but so many of you watching this video right now, you were out here, you put on new roofs, you dug trenches, you replaced all sorts of broken things. So many of you have put in hours and hours of work, time, effort, energy, prayer, and many of you have donated directly to this campus. And so we at Elijah Rising, we just want to say thank you for all of that. We are so excited when we walk through these homes about the progress that's been made here. Tomorrow, these 2 homes that they've been working on will be finished, and they'll be move-in ready after we get some furniture in them. And so that means that the story is just beginning. These homes, as soon as they are, you know, furnished, they'll be move-in ready, they'll be livable, and they'll be ready to receive survivors of sex trafficking. And so this is great. We got a long road ahead of us, and we are excited to see what else God will do as we continue to take this journey together with you. And you as our supporters, our volunteers, our prayer warriors, you know, again, we just couldn't do this without you. And so let's keep going. Let's keep building together. Let's keep providing a place of refuge and safety and hope and healing to survivors together. As these homes open up, we're going to continue to provide the most excellent long-term trauma-informed restorative care that we possibly can. And you make that possible.